the uses of microorganisms one by one. First, the friendly organisms. Some microorganisms are used in the preparation of curd, bread and cake. They are bacteria and yeast. One bacterium called lactobacilli that is used in the making of curd, and yeast is another microorganism, fungi, that is used in the baking of bread, cake and batter of idli, dhokla and pastries and all, etc. Next friendly organism are some other bacteria which helps to fix atmospheric nitrogen into the soil, which makes the soil fertile. Microorganisms are also useful in converting the organic waste like vegetable peels, remains of animals, etc. into harmless and usable substances. So now let us see in detail how bacteria helps in making of curd. Milk is converted into curd by the action of bacteria. As I said, lactobacillus is a bacteria which is present in the curd, and if little curd is added into the milk, this bacterium starts developing and increases in number and converts the entire milk into the curd. Bacteria are also involved in the making of cheese, pickles and other food items. Bacteria present in the curd brings fermentation. If a spoonful of curd is added to the batter of the idli, dhokla or any other batter which we want to get it fermented. Let's see how yeast brings the fermentation in the dough. Yeast reproduces rapidly and produces carbon dioxide during respiration. This carbon dioxide gas fills the dough and increases its volume. Yeast is used in baking industry for making bread, pastries and cake. Commercial use of microorganisms. Microbes are used in the preparation of alcohol, wine, acetic acid, that is vinegar. You should have seen your mother using vinegar as a preservative in many items which she prepares at home. Then uses of yeast. Yeast is a fungi. It is used in the production of alcohol and wine in the industries. For this purpose, the yeast is grown on the natural sugars that are present in the grains like barley, wheat, rice, crushed fruit juices, etc. But let's see what is fermentation. It is a process of conversion of sugar into alcohol, and this process is called fermentation. Yeast is used to convert the sugar into alcohol. Medicinal uses of microorganisms. Microorganisms are used to prepare antibiotics and vaccines. First, let us study about antibiotics. What are antibiotics? Antibiotics are the medicines which are produced from bacteria and fungi. Example, streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin. These are produced from bacteria. And penicillin is another antibiotic produced from fungi. Antibiotics are manufactured by growing specific organisms and used to cure a variety of diseases. Antibiotics are given to the patient either in the form of tablets, capsules or injections. As you can see, the two scientists, Louis Pasteur and another one, Alexander Fleming, these two are the scientists who had developed various antibiotics. These antibiotics kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microorganisms. And antibiotics are also given to livestock like buffalo, cow, etc. and to the poultry. They are given by mixing the antibiotics with the food grains given to them or any other food given to them. And these makes the animals cure themselves from diseases and infections. But we have to be cautious while using the antibiotics. Antibiotics should be used only as prescribed by the doctor. If wrong doses are taken, the drug may become less effective, and whenever necessary, it will not work to cure ourselves from the diseases or infections. And unnecessary use of the drug may kill good bacteria present in our body also. Now let's learn about the vaccine. Vaccine is an inactivated or dead microbes introduced into a healthy body. This microbe helps the body to fight and kill the invading bacteria by producing suitable antibodies. Our body also produces antibodies by itself that attacks the and fights with the foreign bodies that enter our healthy body and kill them. And when these antibiotics are given, they help to produce and increase the number of antibodies so that the patient will recover quickly. These antibodies, that is the vaccine, remains in the body and we are protected from the disease-causing microbes forever. What are the examples of the vaccine? The vaccine is given against the cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox, hepatitis, etc. And these diseases can be prevented by using vaccination. Every one of us are given vaccines since our childhood by our parents. You can ask your parents and find out what all vaccines have been given right from the day you were born till now. And these are given to us to protect ourselves from various diseases. You would have seen the advertisements and the mass promotion campaigns that all the children below the age of 5 are given polio drops. Because our government of India wants to eradicate the polio from the country. So, the polio drops, which are nothing but the inactivated polio organisms or germs that are given to the body so that the child is protected forever. You can refer to the textbook page number 24 for the various diseases and the vaccine given to the patient or any other people to protect themselves.